Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, my
we are so grateful to be. Let us pray.
Yeah,
we give you glory, Lord.
Yes.
You've been good to us.
Amen.
You've been faithful.
Amen.
Through it all.
Yes.
You've shown your might on our behalf.
Amen.
Indeed, Lord, your eyes are upon the righteous.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, you listen to our prayer.
Yes.
Tonight too. We ask that you bless our hearers,
amen,
wherever they may be.
Amen.
Let the word bring healing to somebody who is sick.
Amen.
Let it bring encouragement, Lord.
Yes.
Lift somebody who is down.
Yes,
Lord, in the name of Jesus. May the works of darkness, Lord, be destroyed in the lives of your children.
Yes,
in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight I want to share a word with you that I've titled, Fight the Good Fight of Faith.
There's
a lot going on.
In them a period,
for especially Christians get frustrated because we don't expect things to be that way.
In Kankan, I get it for Ayana, and Abrabo, and I hear I deny a bassa, or send a yeny in the man brain, he ain't the condos at all in on bandam.
So tonight,
in tonight, you breathe.
I'm sharing this word.
Then you are each other,
master. With a passion.
Ah, Mark Menyate.
That God loves you.
Then Yamido.
God cares.
Yami,
no matter the situation.
On Fong Merikumbiara.
In the book of Timothy.
Well, Timothy, one.
Paul spoke to his child.
Paul, on ye Timothy never can say.
How to fight.
Ochiano Kwana Wazuku.
And I'm going to share a few things in Timothy.
Now, on Namanu Mbeche Bibi Kaka.
First Timothy chapter 6, verse 12.
Where
Paul told his son in the Lord, fight the good fight of faith.
And when Paul okay chair about Timothy there,
take hold of the eternal life.
Now cry what down
to which you have been called.
Ah, onam do mo afro.
And about which you made a good confession in the presence of many witnesses.
Ah, onam do me pe mu kan wo adesifu munkum wanyim.
Maybe you also made a confession before people. You gave your life to Jesus in public.
Ebiana wusu epe mu kan wo begum.
And you confess that Jesus Christ is your Lord.
Jesus Christ,
you renounce the ways of darkness. The word of God says, fight the good fight of faith. In 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse
3,
Paul said, share in suffering as a good soldier of Christ Jesus.
As a good
soldier in Christ Jesus.
Share
in suffering. Let me give a third one. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7.
Timothy,
Paul himself said, I have fought a good fight. And I have finished the race.
And
I have kept the faith. So when you put them together, you realize that the fight we are talking about is how to maintain steadfast faith in the
Lord.
And it also shows that the believer is already in a fight, in a struggle. So to fight the good fight of faith means to stay faithful to Jesus Christ. Throughout your life as a believer, not having a roller coaster kind of life. No, be faithful. Whether there are trials or tribulations, no matter the difficulties, beloved, it is not easy. And no fight or war is easy. Especially when you are engaged with somebody who knows the terrain very well.
The devil.
Who fought in heaven. And has come down. And he knows the terrain. He knows what God can do for you. He knows the blessings that are available for you. So scripture says, as a child of God, fight. Fight means you make a decision and you go into it. Let me also make this comment that many of us, many Christians, are following other men and women of God as if to fight for them. Scripture doesn't say someone should fight for you. He says, fight yourself. Do it. So don't waste your time going from left to right, from this mountain to this valley, to this seashore, to that place, just for people to do things for you. As a child of God, God has given the authority to fight. Stand firm on your faith and fight.
No mum today, ye yankupon bay, or today, Gina, a razina sounded ne ku dam or queen.
The two basic things we fight through.
Na ada nefarba, onam do my yazakun nonny.
One is
those can
direct confrontation with satanic and demonic forces.
De yanye abansam and a sinsun fee.
Direct confrontation.
And
it's happening all around us. It's not a matter of you choose to belong or not. 1 Peter 5:8
says,
be sober minded. Be watchful. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a royal. A roaring lion seeking someone to devour.
Now, Abonsema, Oye, Chiasifono, Oyada, Onam, nor Bubom Tede, Yata, Ojebia, Obeseno.
He is horrible.
Oye, or Sayazi.
But he's powerful.
Nemum or Tumso.
He's a wicked spirit.
Oya, Obia Nitsiriaz.
All his desire is to discourage you.
Na listen soon, but take an idea. Obobu Wabum.
To devour you.
In
Ephesians, we learn of he has schemes.
Now, Ephesians of woman, yes, yeah, who there, or yada, or a corner who pinyana, or danda, no, who now or the near him,
just to destroy.
That overstay him.
Every believer
in suggesting you be around
is confronted with Satan and demonic forces.
In suggesting you be around, or yada. He
tempts us to go against God.
Now,
he tries to deceive us in diverse ways. They speak lies. They promote lying.
Now, what chapter? What country some and woman whooped after so
even using men, supposedly men and women of God, to lie, to speak things, to prophesy lies and to say things just to encourage people to be happy in themselves.
Nah, oh yeah, that wasn't numb. In Crawford, wasn't Yamini dinner to Mondo? Nah, off for home. Now, what can't after some and that does some ah, over my hand.
People know they don't have the solution.
And
they pretend as if they have.
They
know very well that they are deceiving people.
Ah, when you prefer them one day,
agents of devil.
Demon Crawfunya, where you're born some new qua ninjumedifo.
If it were possible,
Nasobeya.
Satan would all even want Christians to renounce Jesus and lose their eternity.
Then Joe Obama, I just for Christ in while poor Christ, I'm a one more down one while born.
So that is a basic battle.
In see, a Kubia, a Sassana Yada, a Bessia Christian,
confronting Satan and demons.
That Yanye, born some Nankasa. And since we
have an onslaught against believers.
Now I had where to start.
So do not be surprised, my brother, my sister.
It's a man more young, my brother.
But there is a solution for you.
There is
hope for you.
And you do this or
the second kind of battle.
Now a crowd today be anything
missing physical and spiritual. Emotional and thick trials and difficulties.
Now, a quarter today being here, and Yankasa Abrabomi, a Kutrakana Manzihua, yeah, from a whole no bread, Nina or Yakum.
Some of them is even not directly from God, but from Satan, but God Himself.
Now, if you know what, on fee a resin angasa no more or fee a bonsam.
No, it's not from the devil himself, but from God himself.
On fee a bonsam ho no more or fee a resin one.
Trials can come from God himself.
Oh, yeah, a manzihun or tarnage
because in his wisdom and love.
Send a warning and send a new domain.
He takes us through circumstances, experiences to conform us to the image of his son.
On the emphasis, them and a monomu, amayetum, ya wadanda henma ya seneba Jesus Christ.
Because he has a purpose.
O send a obutebi.
He wants to toughen us.
Ama wash hen.
He wants to be proud of you.
Ama nyamina odzwe tunuhu.
So trust and trust may come from the Lord too.
Or
he has allowed the devil to make it knowing that he has given you enough resources to be able to stand firm.
And as today, Obama Bonsam why ye amma on we razi on yum de wamo was in a botum eginazin.
This is a word of encouragement.
Ye in crunch some amateur bro.
I have said these things to you, Jesus said.
Jesus say, "Ma ken ya chahum."
That you may have peace in me.
That mumune zin hum benyasum.
In the world, you will have tribulation.
Neviasi munzi or your tana manzihu.
Take heart.
Nemum, jinazin.
Take heart.
Ma wakman toyem.
Take heart.
Ma wakman toyem.
I have overcome the world.
Emizi mezi viasi dunkuin.
Beloved, Jesus knows.
Adofu Jesus is
He knows the trials.
Onyim otana
He knows the temptations.
Onyim
that are there for us.
Ah, oh home
in this life.
In
the flesh in which we live.
Wo hunama ye wo mimu.
In the financial and the problem that we go through.
Yes, kasam ahuchena etumwanchi ah ye for mimu.
But he says, take heart.
Osi, how can work much we?
And he said it. In this world, you will have tribulations.
You know,
we
Jesus
can't run away from tribulations.
Yeah, Jesus, okay, we are seeing you fa ota na manzihum.
But he encourages his children, those who have put their faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. He says, if you believe that I'm the Son of God, if you believe that I came to die for you, if you accept that on the third day I'll rise again,
then
remember, all I did was to overcome the devil and all his works. So you have a master, a leader who has gone through every trial and tribulation that we will go through.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we'll have tribulation. We'll have troubles. We'll be persecuted in various ways. Sometimes the persecution comes from your own home. your own family, your own church, your own Christian brethren.
Now, autophobia, dam or ta and amandi hunadi, or bottom if you want us off here, or bottom if you want us unianum, want them web with him, or bottom if you was serum, or bottom if you want us unianum, I get it from home.
These are the fights that we go through. Confronting the Satan and demonic forces directly. They come at you. They do all sorts of things. And then going through troubles and tribulations.
Na damna ota okun oti. Na dam okuna yerkunu. O tum wada hong de. Oti yamba fa o ho na ota na mzimhum. De oba titi hen. Mayen tu miansu mihen yan.
Oh. Facing Satan and demons directly.
And now today, any upon some nankasa in it, since in fee, I owe him a tomb for no, and you want better see them.
How do we fight?
And see, you're better than yet the
Mark. How do we fight?
You're better than yet the Mark.
In Ephesians chapter 6, 10 to 20,
every woman, it's a sia, ninchichem, you do the case.
I'm just listing 4 points here.
Now, maka in samanan.
One, we must use the whole armor of God.
Odinkan nyamina kudzini yina ocha de yeshe.
We can't fight a good fight on our own.
Yen to me and konkupa de yezin ya hu zenro.
But we must use the full armor of God. That's what scripture says.
Namina choice am sa oka. Also, they have fun, young mean angus and now couldn't now cousin ya yadish.
Not what Saul was going to give to David.
And yet, a cousin, na Saul, other come a David.
But he himself couldn't use it to fight Goliath.
Oh, Sunday, the Marcus and Angus went to one fan share and cock and see Goliath.
But what we have. Jesus himself used it against the devil and overcame him.
Jesus nangasa or the yejma na or quinti abonsam no zini to
God's armor involves truth, the belt of truth.
Na nyankupon na kuzin oye ada yede bohenasna oye no kwar.
Walking in truth.
The yen nanti no kwar.
Truthfulness is a wealth, a weapon against the enemy.
De ye no kwar for na yen nanti no kwar. Or ye akuzika sa ye
the
kutia
abonsam shall set you free.
Jesus kade no kwanu obama fanguzi
set you free.
Us no kwanu bama fanguzi.
You may face situations that you think, no, I've got to tell lies, but face the truth, even if it means being killed for it.
Na ebafa amendumbi ma ena obede se izaku hia uhu boto nemmom osede jina manu kwara na se obanda worokumpa jina manu kwara
God help us
nyamina nsa ombo ehia nyina
remain truthful
de ye obobo ehia meya ye nokwafo
the shield of faith
ena oye akuchama.
He says that's what we use akucham. To quench the fiery darts of the enemy.
Oh no, na abonsam nepia na eje na za otutu nyina ye yadigigi.
So learn to grow in faith.
Inti siyembe si ebenyi
mo jezi. Build your faith.
Na mo jezi nyin.
Walking from one place and moving from place to place does not mean you are building your faith. No, you are only dependent upon people to fight your battles for you.
And see, if he comes here, and then of course, if you are now down, aha, now no, suffer no into Mkumkuma. See the ones that now could them queen.
I pray.
No bomb pie there.
Anybody hearing me tonight?
There will be a role
you
bring.
You will begin to fight. You begin to put on your armor. De, develop your faith.
Ever chassis, ne, eze wa kunta dashe, na mo jesu su enin.
Meditate on the scriptures.
Na, drink yankupanasa.
If your faith is as small as a mustard seed, it means that the little word that we know, if we will trust it, it will work miracles for us.
Na, Jesus say. Say he gets it or see there, kitty, there, snappy, a bumpa. But what to wait to tunku, ain't it? Or today, say, Yamina, some cacrining, you made the wood ring, you had the shame, it's who gets the ship. Nessa, it is there. Obey it,
instead of putting your faith and trust in other people.
There, it's who gets his best, come say ye, and answer for be no munu. Obey it, it's who gets the best, Yamina, some kitty.
And more very important is the sword of the Spirit. Which is the word of God.
Na akuda no so kanwa no so ohie ye no so ye
Unfortunately, many believers are refusing even to read the scriptures once a week. Are you maintaining a daily devotion with your God? Are you maintaining moments of meditation on the Word of God? It is the sword. It is an armor. And it is what you use to destroy the works of the enemy. So, we must put on the full armor of God. I can't spend all the time on this, but let me move on to the second one. We must also believe the promises of God. Oh my goodness.
Hallelujah.
The promises of God are yea and amen in Christ. Matthew 5:18, Jesus says, heaven and earth will pass away, but not an iota of the word. Every promise that God has will be fulfilled for his children. So, in fighting, learn to develop, learn to put on the full armor of God. Believe in the promises of God. Believe it. Take them. Listen, if it is in the word of God, take it. Believe it. Number three, pray at all times. Pray for strength. Pray for wisdom. God's guidance. Pray for deliverance from evil and temptations. Scripture says, with all prayer and supplication. I'm rushing to the end, and next week, God willing, we'll take a few things a bit deeper. But we must pray at all times. Ephesians 6:18. The last point I'll give you here is pray for others too. You may be going through some tough times, but don't only focus on your need. Pray for others. Pray for your pastors and your leaders. Don't think that they are so powerful, they don't have any problem. Pray for others.
Because
as you water,
you
yourself will be watered. Even Paul said,
Paul can
make supplications for all the saints. And also for me. So that I have the power, the strength to speak to preach the word.
And
church members, pray for your pastors.
You don't
pray for them, and then when they make a mistake, you criticize.
That's
Ephesians 6:18 and 19. So a good fight. A good fight of faith. Means that you deny yourself and walk in total obedience, loving and encouraging others, sharing the gospel faithfully. Give to the poor, give to others. So listen. All I've said tonight is that Paul encourages us to fight a good fight. You may be going through a trial, but don't give up. Fight a good fight. Remember that the end is God's victory. Our end as human beings on earth may be terrible, but when we remain faithful in the Lord, it is a glory to Him. Because then you will hear, "Thou good and faithful servant," because you did not renounce your faith. You did not compromise with the world. You did not compromise with the devil. That is what God is pleased with.
We are
fighting two basic things. Satan and demonic forces.
We are
working through trials and temptations.
And
how we fight is to put on the whole armor of God. Believe the promises of God. Pray at all times. Yes. Many people are lazy when it comes to prayer meeting. At home, you will not pray. You can't even pray much. Get together with people to who encourage you to pray to. You would rather spend time behind the TV watching movies or on your phone watching other things or going to places where it's not relevant for your spiritual growth.
But
also remember, don't focus on only yourself. Pray for others, even Paul said, pray for me. These are the few things I can have with you tonight.
Find a good fight.
May God encourage you in whatever situation you are in. Tonight, we encourage you. Don't give up. We won't have time for calls. But if you have any need, you want to be prayed with, you have a question, I would like you to gather courage and call me. Next week, we'll continue with this message, and then I'll open the lines for people to bring their contributions or ask questions.
Now, the Sunday, you both saw the mass and paid you. Now, you boy, I'm a trophy at Roma. It was in Bisa Ibiza, and now today, it was some to do become none so I can.
Till next week.
Kesi, the Sunday, the ABC, and
God bless you.
Nyami Unshaw.
Thank you.
Head of mercy.
So I would love to hear from you. If you like to talk with me, you have any peculiar problem, call 024-689-4255. 024-689-4255. 4250. If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, you can also call that number or seek anybody who will encourage you how to be a child of God.
Nti sɛ wo hobi anase de adesie bia ebotu ma fresh of any number na odi to God. The marathon I say epede ezi wa brabo ma Jesus Christ a. The ma banara so ebotu ma fresh na onye ubezi nkomo.
May God lead you to fight and win your battles in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Nyamina nzukan na kunkun na zinkunim with Jesus' name.
God bless.
Nyamin shalom.